This is Huawei's new Matebook D16, a 16-inch laptop that is powered by Intel's 12th generation chips. There are two models with the Core i5, but this review unit here that Huawei sent out to me, it's a loan unit too, by the way, does have the Core i7. It's the 12700H. And compared to the previous gen with the 11th gen Intels, this is quite a big step up in performance. So this model here comes with either 8 GB of RAM or 16 GB, which I do have, and 512 GB SSDs, which are PCIe 3. It's got Wi-Fi AX, so that's Wi-Fi 6, a 60-watt-hour battery, and a backlit full-sized keyboard. It also does run Windows 11 Home. So in this video, I'm going to go over it in detail, and I'll let you know all the pros and cons now in my time, which is a week of testing out the Matebook D16 from Huawei. In the box, you'll find a warranty card, our Type-C to Type-C cable, which is of a good length, and then the charger. So it's Huawei's Supercharge, 65 watts Type-C charger. It will also work with other Huawei products, and I really like just how small and compact it is. Laptop has a nice alloy finish to it. So this is the gray version. You can also get a silver one, and it is a matte paint finish to it. You can see here the embossed Huawei logo. The hinge does feel very good. Opening it up, there is a little bit of a lip here, but as you can see, I cannot open it up one hand. You do need two hands to open this one up. We're presented now with a normal full-sized keyboard here with good travel. It's about 1.6 millimeters, very comfortable to type on. It is a backlit keyboard. Now pressing down firmly there in the middle, there really is not that much flex. It's a very small amount that it does have. Half-size arrow up and down keys, but we do get a full-size numerical keyboard here too. So we've got the number pad, which is great for those that want it. Now you will see that the touchpad is off-centered when you look at it, but if you factor in the keyboard, which is just in front, it's actually in the center. So that's why they've moved it to one side, because of our number pad right here. Various different shortcuts, we've got them along here. You've got print screen, and by default, we do have all of the controls up here. So for example, the screen brightness, our media controls, Huawei Share, by default, if you needed F2 or F3, then you have to push the function key there for those. So like the keyboard, the palm rest here is made out of the same alloy, which is brush, that paint job. And here our power button also has a fingerprint reader for Windows Hello. So very fast just to use this to log in instead of having to type out a password. This keyboard is also backlit. So this is the first stage, the first light level, and then the second, which is the brightest. It's evenly distributed, so I don't see any dull patches at all. The touchpad on this model, it does support Windows 11 gestures, as you'd expect, and we have a built-in left and right mouse button. It's not super large, but the size I do find is adequate, and I've got no complaints. It is an accurate touchpad, and even the finer movements, the cursor does not jump around all over the place. It works really well. Now the underside of the Matebook D16 still has that alloy finish, so it feels good. We've got little torque screws holding everything in place, and unfortunately, because this is a loan unit, I'm not allowed to open it up and show you the internals. We've got two downward firing speakers, rubber feet at the front here, and a larger rubber foot, but it does have this gap in the middle to help with the airflow. So this is where the cooler air will be sucked in, and that is then blown out the back, and I'll cover the thermals in this review too. On the right side of the Matebook D16, we do have a USB 2 port and USB 3.2 Gen 1. So it's a little unusual they put a USB 2 on here. Now I'll just be plugging my mouse into it, so it doesn't really matter, but I do believe that two USB 3.2s would have been a little better. But we do get two Type-C ports here on the left, status LED right there. Now they both support power delivery, but one of them does support video out 4K 60. We've got HDMI 2.0, so not HDMI 2.1, which the hardware does support. However, connecting up my LG CX 4K 120Hz TV, I can end up running 120Hz 4K, which is good. 3.5 millimeter headphone jack with mic support. Quality out of this is loud, it's clear. There's no annoying static, so that's great. And keeping with the tech that they've brought through originally with the Matebook X line, we have now the four microphones at the front. So I like the location. They bring the mics closer to you. And the fact that there are four of them, the sound quality from these mics is definitely superior to other laptops that only have two either side of the webcam. Looking at the laptop closely, I can see that it just seems to have the single cooling fan, so not a twin setup like we see on the MateBook X Pro series. So it'll be interesting to see how this is going to fare the thermals, especially in the performance mode. The screen we have in the MateBook D16 is 16 inches, even though the form factor and the size of the laptop is about that of a 15.6 inch laptop. So we have matte bezels around the outside. There is a little plastic, well, rubber lip around the edge here to stop it from scratching up when the lid is closed. You can see up the top here, that's our 1080p AI camera. There's a status LED next to it. The left and right bezels are nice and slim. We do have the Huawei branding here that you can see. So the screen itself, it's IPS, 1920 by 1200 is the resolution. It's not super sharp, but at normal viewing distances, it does still look fine. I would have preferred 1440p at this size, especially the 16 inches, but I think for most people, it's still going to be adequate. It's still fine and looks good when you look at it. So the screen here, brightness they claim is 300 nits. But measuring it with my Spider X Pro, it turns out to be over their claim, which is 317 nits of brightness. So indoors, with the anti-glare coating, it does look good, and I find it perfectly acceptable, this brightness. I would have, of course, preferred to have brighter, but it's actually perfectly fine for most people. And even in direct sunlight with the anti-glare coating, you can still make it out. So the color coverage here, the gamut, sRGB is 97%, NTSC, that is 69%, Adobe RGB 74%, and P3 coverage is also 74%. So all up, it's a good screen, but not quite, definitely not at the level of what we get on their more expensive MateBook X models. And here we are in Windows. Now, normally with my reviews, I would show you the BIOS, but really there's nothing to show you with Huawei machines because it's locked down, so you can't adjust power limits. You can't really make any changes apart from boot order and secure boot. You can disable that too. So it does run Windows 11 Home. We've got the 16 gigabytes of RAM, of which most of it is available to us. They've dedicated a tiny little bit to the Iris Xe graphics, but that will scale up automatically anyway. Now, the general performance of this laptop is very good. It's exceptionally quick and fast, so there's no need for me to show you documents, spreadsheets, browser performance, because that is all really quick. Everything's instantaneous. There's no lag when you pop up the menu or anything like that on lower spec machines that I do often cover in my channel. Now, you will see here that it's listed as quad channel RAM, but it's not actually. Now, what they're using is low powered DDR4 RAM, and it can actually clock itself right up to 4267 megahertz, but they haven't gone with DDR5, which is a little interesting with this. Now, you will see here too, we've got Iris Xe graphics. Now, this does have 96 executional units, and it's not bad graphics at all for integrated, that is, at least. So the CPU, which is of course the Core i7, the 12700H, very potent. It's got a lot of cores, so six performance cores, and it can clock up to 4.7 gigahertz, eight efficiency cores. So that is why when you look here too in the device manager, which I'll quickly bring up, you'll see that, hang on, there's 20 processors listed here. Well, 20 cores. That's because of the threads too. So in total, we've got 20 threads. It's an absolute monster, as you'll see with benchmarks later on. The 12th gen is a huge, massive step up from the 11th gen. And I'm so glad that Huawei finally does have it. So it's a very potent CPU there. General performance, very good. I'll just quickly show you what it's like at video playback. So this is the 4K demo file that I always do play. And I'll just play this with films and TV. Now, it always does this for some reason, Windows. There's a bit of a stutter at the beginning. It's a very demanding bitrate too, 140 megabits per second. It's when you resize it or first play it, but after that, it's really smooth and no problems with it. And the Sony Swordsmith, so this is 4K 60 video playback. You'll see again that this one, very, very quick. And initially it does that little pause for some reason. So the performance of that is great. So anything you throw at it, it can handle it when it comes to video files, this spec of PC. Then a few benchmarks here. You can see the performance, as I mentioned before, is impressive. So the single core score here with Cinebench R23, really high. They've made a big step up, Intel, with the 12th gen with this. And then the multi-core score here, this could actually be a little bit better. Now, I did run it in the performance mode, But after 10 minutes of it looping, the score slowly ends up dropping down a little bit because we do have some thermal throttling that is taking place. Now, I've been running this here in the background to monitor those thermals, and you can see it ended up hitting 100 degrees. So that's why it's not quite as good then after 10 minutes because it ended up throttling down a little bit. So we also have the Geekbench 5 score here, which is impressive. So that's when it is performing without throttling. Now, this is when I use the function P. I'll just show you. You can swap between here a balance mode and a performance mode. Now, in balance mode, it doesn't end up throttling, but with a performance mode, it does. However, you get slightly faster speeds. Increases that power limit up to 54 watts. So that's a very strong score there. And the SSD that they have used is a 512 gigabyte one in this model that I have. And you see that this is clearly PCIe 3.0 speed. So they didn't, again, use a PCIe 4 spec SSD, which, of course, this 12th gen does support. Now, I don't know why they've done that, but, well, we probably know what the reason is. It's probably cost-saving why they didn't go for DDR5 RAM or a PCIe 4 SSD to keep the price of this down. Then our included software we do get with the MateBook D16. So there is this, which is Huawei's PC Manager. Now, this is not what I would classify as bloatware, and in fact is very handy. So you've got here your devices that are paired up to your Huawei account, other Huawei devices you can connect up there. Huawei Share, so I have covered this before in my other reviews. It's a very handy way of seamlessly connecting up your, say, Huawei P50 Pro. You can transfer files over. You can also answer text messages and things like that all wirelessly. You can set it up as a second display if you've got a tablet too. So very handy, and you've got some tips, troubleshooting there, quick services. But for me, this is the best, optimization. So you can set and update here all of the drivers. Now, I did have two BIOS updates that have come through already, and I updated all of the drivers here. So one spot, very easy to do, which is great. And you also do have this, which is performance tuning. So you can set it to balance, which is by default, or performance. But that also works, as I mentioned before, with the function P shortcut. So you can go over then into the balance mode or the performance. Performance does increase the power limit, really does boost the speed, but the trade-off is more heat's generated. The fans will come on a little bit more, as you would expect. There is this then too, the control panel, which is some pretty obvious straightforward shortcuts there. Instant hotspot, another handy one. Audio devices, and then configuration for that 1080p AI camera, which I'll give you a sample of now with those four microphones. The webcam is 1080p, and when you're using it in the standard mode right now, it is 30 frames per second. The audio you're listening to recorded on those four front-facing microphones. So this is tech that they've pulled through from the MateBook X line, the more expensive line, into the more affordable D series here. Now, I'll just change the background to show you that it's actually going to work. It's a global setting, so it's going to work with any apps. And right now, this is what they call the living room background, which looks rather nice. And we've got the meeting room, the office, and then blurry. So that's another one. If you wanted to, for example, hide all your mess in the background, you can blur it. Now, you can see the stitching at times won't be perfect. Now, that's normal. You can see how when I put my hand up, okay, it's stitching that out all right, but if I move around too fast, it could look a little funny. Now, they do have the auto centering mode, but that does not work with the AI background removal. So it's centering in, it's cropped in a little bit. You'll notice that the quality has, yes, dropped off a little bit. However, if I move over to this side, you'll see that the camera will then follow me, which it's doing, and keep me in the frame centered. So quite good, the features they do offer here, especially nowadays with the needs of many of having, of course, better, higher quality webcams. So I really like the background stitching effect that I can blur them out. And overall, I think the MateBook D16 does have an excellent webcam, and I like these AI features.
And then the loudspeakers. So as I showed you before with the webcam sample, that the microphones sound really good, but does it have the speakers to back it up? Well, they're not bad, but they're not amazing either. They're certainly not at the level that we do get with the MateBook X Pro, for example, much more expensive than this model. They're reasonable speakers. So here's a sample of them at 100% volume. There's a little bit of bass, there's some treble there, but that's nothing that's really gonna blow you away. They're adequate speakers. And just how is the 12700H then at video editing? So this is a very light, basic 4K edit. They are 100-bit files. Playback, it's not dropping any frames, but I only have it set to a quarter playback resolution there. Now, without a dedicated GPU, complex video edits will eventually, depending if they're very large, the size of them, will eventually run into some slowdown and lag. But something basic like this, the Core i7 12th Gen can definitely handle. Then export times, very quick. So I have 1 minute of footage here, which is the YouTube 4K preset. And you'll see that it rips through that really quick, only taking about 39 seconds to export 1 minute of footage. That's an excellent result. So can it game? Well, it's not a gaming laptop, but older titles at lower resolutions. So this, for example, this is The Witcher 3. It's 720p on low settings is playable here. You can see around 40, just over 40, up to about 47 frames per second, which is not bad, even 50 here. And this is in the busy town, which does have a lot of, the game has a lot of graphics to render and also all the NPCs and everything, but it is dipping down a little bit. But yes, you can play older titles, Counter-Strike, GTA 5, Half-Life 2, things like that will all be very playable, even at 1080p on this 12th gen with the Iris Xe graphics and its 96 executional units. And what kind of fan noise can you expect to out of the laptop? So when I'm doing something demanding, like gaming, for example, you hear it. It's on all of the time. If you're doing something light, you don't really hear the fan that much. Here is a sample of it under full load. I did do a quick test boot here of Linux, and I ran into some difficulty with the touchpad drivers. So that's one thing you're going to have to sort out if you do intend to run Linux on the Matebook D16.
Then our battery runtime. So just the brightness set at 30%, office tasks on this, so documents, spreadsheets, YouTube browsing, 6 hours and 55 minutes was what I was able to achieve out of it, which is all right for a 60 watt hour battery. But of course, if you do something very demanding, it's really going to bring down that battery life there. So the things I like about the Matebook D16, well, the build quality, very good, really good keyboard, backlit, good touchpad, great screen, really good webcam, very good microphones. They brought that through from the more expensive Matebook X Pro series that I've also covered and reviewed too in the channel. And it does have quite a bit of features packed into it with the Huawei Share. We've got Type-C ports on them, but we don't have Thunderbolt 4 with this, and it doesn't use DDR5 RAM, and it does not have a PCIe 4.0 spec SSD. So using last gen with some things, but we do have the 12th gen. Now, why have they done that? It's obvious. They're trying to keep down the cost of it to deliver a lower price point. So I really hope that with a future model, they could probably bring it out with also Thunderbolt 4, but you need to, at this point, get the more expensive Matebook X Pro line, which will have that and the faster RAM. And I do hope they start using PCIe 4.0 spec SSDs. The only real con that I did encounter was if you push it really hard in the performance mode, which is increasing the power limit from 45 watts to 54 watts, you run into thermal throttling, doing something very demanding, like running Cinebench, which I was looping there for 10 minutes. It got up to 100 degrees Celsius. It throttled, it lowered the clocks, and it did lower the performance a little bit. Apart from that, it is a fantastic 16-inch laptop that is really in the form factor of a 15.6-inch one with a great 1.7 kilo weight to it. Thanks a lot for watching this review. Do hope to see you in the next one. Bye for now.